shit.
I don't know.
Nigga, this.
You got a whole wall of like.
A whole wall of that. Nigga, the whole wall of LED strips. Carl in the background with a little LED remote. Changing the colors.
Now you gotta get somebody for that.
Bizarre, and what does it mean to be bizarre?
That's dope. Rich Bizarre is a creative artist that does pretty much everything in the art world. I do visual art, from painting and spray painting and stuff like that. I also do graphic design, some set designing as well. So that's most of what I do, even some creative branding. But like I said, anything creative or artistically, that any artistic need, I probably do it. What it means to be bizarre. What it means to be bizarre to me is just to just be fearless, try to just be edgy, man, and just whoever you are, whoever you feel you are inside, just be that and then bask in that in the best way that you possibly can. Bizarre is a French word for weird. Weird is something I like to break down as just being different, man. People only say things is weird when they don't understand it. So, you know, that's kind of like how I live my life, man. Just being bizarre, and if you don't get it, you don't get it. It wasn't meant for you. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm from Brooklyn, New York, Red Hill Projects, born and raised. Moved to Atlanta, Georgia a little bit after high school. Went to high school for graphic arts. That's where I learned my graphic skills. Graphic arts in Manhattan was where I did my 4 years of high school. Kind of got my skills from there. And then once I got out of high school, started playing around with music, abandoned my art talents for a while. And I guess as I really did music, I think as I did music, I've learned myself a lot more. You know what I'm saying? And it brought me right back to who I really was and where I started. Which was art, because it's just a free range. Music can be so sometimes constraining, and they kind of want to box you in to make certain type of songs and things like that. But with art, you can just be fully expressive. So I got back on that. Even though throughout my music time, I was still kind of exercising my art talents, from shooting videos for myself. I was kind of already sharpening my set designing skills. Designing my own flyers and cover art, I was kind of sharpening my graphic skills. So once I kind of just went full time with it and locked in to just the art, I already had the skills I needed. So I just spent a little bit more time sharpening my craft, and now I have my own company called Bizarre's Dope. So that's pretty much some of my background and where I am now. So like set designing is like really cool to me, because it's kind of like bringing things from the imagination into reality, or like just kind of painting pictures. Like if someone had a video and they were trying to make a certain visual, set design kind of allows you to tap into another world. Like growing up, I remember going to like Universal Studios in Orlando, stuff like that, and getting on those rides where the rides were kind of like you got to be in the movie, kind of. I kind of had a love for just doing that set stuff just based off of that. So now that, you know, I link with my boy Carl, we've been doing stuff with the Cool Life, you know what I'm saying? And me and him linked actually through music when I was shooting a video he shot for me. And he's the one who kind of like woke up the set designing beast in me. So yeah, that's pretty much so. And it led to some big projects. We've worked on some for T.I. and Trans Lee. A few other things that we're currently working on. You'll be seeing a lot from that soon. The struggles of it is, one, not knowing when you're gonna be paid. When you're gonna, you know what I'm saying? And this is how you live, this is how you eat, this is how you pay your bills. Not knowing when to be paid, trying to make people understand your worth. to understand that you are worth being paid what you're asking for. So those are definitely some of the struggles. And then just finding that niche to where you have that constant money flow coming in. That's some of the struggles. The best part about it is waking up and doing what you love every day, which is the cool life. The cool life is creating our own lives. So it's literally just loving what you do, waking up every day and doing what you're best at. So that's the best part about it. Like and the fact that now I'm at a point where I can get paid to do what I love is even better. Bazaar is dope to me. It's just a brand. It's just a brand for people who are not scared to be out this outside the box. People who don't live by any kind of guidelines. You know what I'm saying? You just do your thing, and if it feels right, it looks right, and it seems right, then it's right for you. Then that's what it is. So Bazaar is dope. It's pretty much like the artwork and stuff that I produce is all kind of edgy. Mixing some of the mediums that I do, you know, kind of like some of the styles that I do, it might not be quote unquote what the art world will accept every time, or sometimes it's not even what people can even see. If I explain something that I'm about to do to the average person, they might not even get or understand what I'm talking about. So being bizarre is just that. It's just doing the unthinkable, you know what I'm saying? And I'm just trying to present it to the world in a different kind of way, just in a well put together way, something that people can gravitate to a little bit more. Yeah, I've been blessed with a few situations that has definitely catapulted my independent career. So once I took that leap of faith to do it full time, is like when everything kind of opened up. So I know I got I did the video with T.I. Trans Lee, Cassius Wave, where I did a lot of the set design for it, as well as supplied the artwork for the video as well. Those things kind of led into me meeting different people in the set designing world. I was about to work on a dope project with Gucci and 21 Savage, but you know, dates got conflicted with that. But it also led to me doing MTV, where MTV I did some graphic design work for the election campaign, which was something that was really dope. That was a big move for me graphically. I've never kind of crossed that threshold with my graphic design. Did a piece for Jacquees. What else? And I mean, every from there, it's just now just constantly working, and just everything else is kind of on the way. You know what I mean? I don't even really want to speak on it. It's just everything to come now. So all of these crazy connections also, they all open up different doors. It was just crazy. But so Trap Museum reached out to me maybe about 3 days ago, asked me to create three individual pieces for each of the Migos. So I had like 9 days to create that, and it's going pretty smooth. At first I was a little skeptical about it because of how full my plate is right now, but you know, I've been on this wave of just accepting everything that comes. Like if it comes, accept it and see what doors God opens, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, I took the leap of faith and just say, yeah, I can do it, I'm gonna do it. And it led to me even finding like a new style that I even kind of like for doing some of those quick portraits. You know what I mean? So everything is sharpening muscles too. Like things that I didn't think I can bust out in a certain time frame is just pushing me now. It's dope now, like doing art. It was a struggle with music. Oh, I'm sorry. Now that I'm doing art, it's definitely a dope situation. Doing art or being a creative in Atlanta. Doing music was a little different because I think I was coming from New York, and coming to Atlanta, the sounds were different. The time was different. You know what I mean? So trying to find that wave was a struggle. But now that I'm like doing my art, I think art connects worldwide to anybody. So it's opening up a pocket for me, and being that Atlanta is big, but it's not so big. If you kind of get in certain circles, like, you know, you'll kind of get your name out there in Atlanta. So it's been working in my favor. There's a lot of artists that I definitely look up to. King Saladin is he's a dope artist, like really dope. I love like how he blends his different mediums. Like it's kind of bizarre and edgy, like a lot how I would say mine's is. There's an artist in Atlanta, his name is Hobo, and he's really dope. He's somebody that I would say like is somebody I would like to work with artistically sometime in the future. Other than that, like I want to work with Travis Scott, like for real, man. Like that's what I want to do. I want to like do some sets or something for Travis, because I feel like his whole creative like vibe is everything that I do naturally. You know what I'm saying? Like that's what I create. So yeah, those are some people that I rock with.
Name three key things you've learned in business.
One is time management. for sure. Like managing your time, taking, because you are dealing with other people's product at the end of the day, and you are dealing with other people's items that they use for their business, so or for whatever they might do. So yeah, time management is really big. Budgeting your money. Being an entrepreneur, it comes with a lot of sacrifices. And going into it, you got to understand that you can't be doing all of the stuff that your regular, you know, that your friends do or whatever on the regular, like just going to turn up, blowing money, doing whatever like that. Sometimes you gotta look at things a little bit different and be smart with every coin. Invest in, and the more you invest in, the more you'll reap, the more you'll see back. Something else is being consistent and just constantly working. Being consistent, constantly working, like you only get better. You only get better with each project. As you go through each project, you get better. And just pay attention and learn from each one. And yeah, you'll be on your way. Definitely, I would definitely say take that leap if you feel it's in your heart to do it. But before just taking the leap, make sure you execute. And understand, like if you have certain things going on within your life that you know requires attention or money, or you know what I'm saying, like you got to plan each little part. Stack up, you know, get, if you got certain bills, maybe stack a few months of it up. Understand, and before you even take that leap, really ask yourself, do you even feel like, have you been pushing yourself with a job first, like with the 9-to-5? How hard are you pushing yourself? Are you going to your 9-to-5 and then you shutting off when you go home? Like how much percentage of yourself are you giving in compared to your 9-to-5? And if you're giving your nine to five more, then that means you're not ready to take that leap of faith. So you take that leap of faith when you know that you're giving your independent hustle more. Like if that's coming before everything. And you know you got things coming in, so where if this job stops, you know you still got a groove going with your own thing. That's when I feel like you can go ahead and take that leap. Life, period. I just want to, like, my bucket list is to literally be able to travel and do my art, like, in each place that I go. That's what it is for me. I love traveling. Like, traveling is my favorite thing to do more than anything. I pretty much work and want to get money just to travel, but to be able to do that and also do what I love in each place and leave my mark behind in each place that I go in some kind of cool way, that'd be dope. So that's my creative bucket list. So this piece right here, I got this piece right here. It's called Obstacles. What it is pretty much octopus. Inside of an astronaut helmet, which inside of the astronaut helmet, the octopus's head is a brain. So this piece is pretty dope to me because for one, it was like my first time trying something original. Like just trying to test my skills of doing something outside of like cartoons or painting celebrities or something like that. But the actual meaning of the piece is what connected to me the most, was because I found myself doing all of these different things that I've mentioned throughout the interview, like, you know, like I said, creative design, set design, and all of that graphic design stuff. So I had to be able to stretch myself in different places and work my mind a lot more. But I knew that if I worked my mind and I achieved doing all of those different things around me, if I was able to put my hands on on all of the different tasks at hand and perform well and do them right, I knew they would elevate me and take me to a place that I've never been. So that's why it's kind of like going out of space and all of that, because it's just me kind of stretching my limbs, doing everything and elevating myself, working my mind. That's what this piece means to me. But yeah, this right here is another piece that it's really dope to me. It's Basquiat, somebody who I felt like was also like very misunderstood, was very edgy. He just did whatever felt right to him, and I mean, it took him, you know, it took him the way it took him. But more so the quote that's on the back was something that was, I guess he tagged in New York City when he was alive. And it says, the whole lively line bowed like this, with the big money all crushed into these feet. And I pretty much took that as like the whole working for like that corporate 9-to-5 world. Like, I felt like that's what it was. It's just like, if working for them, making them the big buck, and us getting, when he says like crushed down to their feet, you know, that makes me feel like it's like we're making them the money, but we're pretty much minimized and constrained. And they tell us, you know, how much we're gonna make and when we are able to have vacations and when it's like we form to what they want to and what they need, you know what I'm saying? Just to better themselves and better their company. So me going into my entrepreneurial and then just kind of like just my whole life working like the nine to five world has just been the worst. It's literally been the worst. Like, I can't name one 9-to-5 that was actually something that I enjoyed or whatever. So, you know, I always kind of felt these certain ways. So when I came across, you know, this piece that I seen him tag, it just spoke to me a lot. And then I was already a fan of, you know, his work and stuff like that, but was never nothing to make me want to just paint him or nothing like that. But when I saw that, it made sense. So painted him, and I used his alias, Samo, on the bottom. So yeah. Closing remarks. I definitely want to close with saying my art show Area 51 is, you know, that's what I'm currently working on, which is the biggest thing to me. It's also the business launch for myself, for my company, Bazaar is Dope. So I'm gonna be kind of like showcasing all my creative talents, set design, graphic arts, visual arts, all of that stuff is gonna be displayed at this show in a really, really cool way, with, you know, design sets for each piece. Dope installations. Like, you'll be able to come to the art show and really be a part of the art and experience it in a cool way. So yeah, that's what I've been caved in working on for the past 6 months, and that's something that I need everybody to come out to and check out. It's gonna be really major. Hopefully I changed the way people view art, people are able to receive art, as well as the way people do art shows. Yo, yo, it's your boy, Yo Rich Bazaar. Thank you for watching my interview with Art Life Vibes. Follow up. To bring y'all this creation right here, Area 51, which is pretty much y'all coming in and seeing something that I've kept hidden for the past 6 months. Just as Area 51 is quote unquote highly aliens. But yeah, today I just wanted to give my life and a little bit of myself in the most creative way I possibly could. I've never done a solo art show. I've always been a part of things in our community. This is the first time that I actually put it up in my own production. Been doing this independent for the past year, since last January. I've been pretty much been able to fuel my life off of what's happening with my creativity, and it's something that I've always dreamed of my entire life. I've tried to do music, you know, couldn't really make that happen like what I wanted to. But you know, all of those creative branches kind of all built into this. Me shooting videos, doing music, kind of taught me a little bit about set design. So just being able to like start to illustrate that out with my art as well. So yeah, I just hope y'all really, really, truly enjoy it. Y'all take a good tour around. The back is open. A lot of people don't know that there is a back
yes.
to this exhibit.
Go to the black curtain and then go to the white curtain.
Yes, that is the finish point to the tour. So yeah, it starts from over there, and as you walk around, just read the installation details, and it'll let you know what they meant to me and what I was trying to do with the installation. So yeah, hope y'all enjoy. Thank you for coming out again.
Yeah.
Prints available of all of the art that you see here. There's prints available. I also have prints of like old stuff that I did that's not here. So yeah, take a look at the prints. Get y'all some drinks. We got the Bazaar Culture Reader. Shout out to my team, Creative Culture, for whipping that mix up for me. So yeah, enjoy. Get y'all some good flicks and tag Area 51 art exhibit. Hashtag Area 51 art exhibit. Thank you.